Good morning, YouTube. So, we have quite a few things on the agenda for today. So I'm gonna try to knock this truck out. Unfortunately, Okay Man is a little under the weather today. So, I am gonna have to try to knock out some of this stuff here. So, I see in the comment section, y'all were talking smack.
Okay Man's doing everything, you're not doing anything to the truck, such and such.
Okay, all right, just you wait. So, I'm trying to figure out the hardware on these seats. I have to go down to McCoy's to get some extra screws and bolts and stuff. Make some modifications here. So I figured out that the base mounts here, because they just gave me everything. I didn't have a chance to see what goes where. So I've mounted the base on here, really with one screw just to make sure it fits. And then this seat goes on top right here. So these two line up. So I mounted this on here. This goes on here. The screw goes up in the bottom. There's like a little mount up under the seat right here. So the passenger seat, we're gonna have to rig something up because I don't have the base to that one. So, but nobody's really gonna be sitting in that seat, so I don't really need anything too special. So, here, I'll show y'all. So we have this here. So I don't really have a base like that one, so I'm gonna have to figure something out for this one here. I bought two more shocks. Y'all know I'm increased the size of my shocks. So I got them that big right there. These two smaller ones here, I'm taking those off and putting the bigger shocks on there. Got to fix their air leak. We figured out how the part goes on there. Shout out to you, Cisco, for that little tutorial. And then we figured out the grill situation, which we'll get into that later. We'll try to get that grill installed. So, but Caveman has given me full access to the shop. And so with all the tools, welding equipment, everything. So today's my turn to shine. So let's get to work. So y'all sit back, relax, and let's get to work. Some more screws. Let's put some washers through these just to play it safe. Probably should have added one on the bottom of this too, but we'll be okay. So let's put one on the opposite end so it lines up. Where did I just have it? Oh, here it is. Cool. All right. So now I'll take this. I think that goes on like that. All right. Let's see if we have enough washers here. So I think this goes on right about there. All
find it. Come on, baby. Just need to line up more.
Up installing where are they at? Do I not have any more? Guess not. But anyway, forget it.
Seats are in there.
Who cares how I got them in there? But we're good. Oh, didn't mean to do that. Let's make sure that it doesn't move too much. Okay, I need to tighten that bass down just a little bit more. But other than that, we're good.
Thank you. It works.
Huh? Yeah, I'm making sure we're for the air, for the airlines. It works. Mm-hmm. That was just trying to make sure there was no in the seat. And yeah, it works. I know, right? For two. It works, no leaks. So we're gonna go ahead and put these on here properly. All right. Got a little air sprayer here. Oh, I still got the air leak on the bottom, so we'll have to address that. All right. So this is the seat here. Sounds like Caveman is up. All right. Cool. That is installed. Now I do have a second airline there. Just gonna put one of these bad boys on it. And then that's gonna be for the passenger seat. So, all right, seats are done. Let's go, let's do the shocks.
Feeling better, sir? All right, so those two are done. Hopefully we don't have any issues with these front shocks, but. Thank you.
I didn't want to damage the threads at the bottom.
Oh, you're all right as long as you ain't beating the shit out of it. You know what I mean?
Yeah, it's coming out.
I'd be able to just mount it on there, and it'd probably be easier to mount it and then pull it.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
It's that fifth wheel arm.
Oh, it's in the way.
Yeah. Okay.
So we should just overstretch it.
Yeah.
And then push it back down.
Okay. Actually, let me see that one.
If you pay attention to which way.
Yeah, the nut was, of course, on the inside.
No, I'm talking about this way. Right. Was this on the outside or this?
Oh, okay. Yeah, I'll look at that.
This should have been on the outside. Maybe left to us. I think the small side, yeah, that's the way we did these.
Okay.
Yeah, small side to the outside.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what I was able to do with the other one, but this one ain't gonna work like that.
Right.
Man, we need to grab something and get all this damn pumps of grease off your shit.
Yeah.
It's gonna melt and cause more of a mess. DOT sees grease all over your truck. I know you're using it.
I know, right?
greased your fifth wheel in the trailer and pushed it off. You know, looking at that wheel, it's probably time for another one. Right?
Shocks to put on, y'all. Got that one on. Got that one on over there. Yeah, the other shocks, they were done for. Definitely. Yeah, these are way bigger. But like the old ones, I can bend back and forth with my hands. And it's not supposed to be like that. Oh, wow, these brackets look good, y'all. If this bumper goes anywhere, it was meant to be gone. So he went ahead and made one go across there. He's got one that's going down there. So the bumper can't flimsy that way or bounce up and down. Okay, so he's got that one in right there. So I'm assuming he's making one right now. The one he's bending goes right across there. Cool. Brackets look good. So the brackets look good. That bumper ain't going nowhere. Yeah.
Doing all that crap anyway.
If that bumper falls off, it was meant to be.
If the bumper falls off, lose my number.
No, I'm just kidding. Right? Sweet. And then you guys, you know, last night we could not finish the grill on the truck. Well, guess what? I went through some stuff and I found the missing pieces that we needed. They must have fell out the box inside the truck. So we did all that for nothing yesterday. But anyway, yeah, he's just lining these up. Yeah, it's gonna be dope. All right, y'all. All right, seat check. He's working on that. So we're gonna do the radiator flush last because we don't want the ground to be wet. So I guess now I have to climb under the truck to get their air leak resolved, which I'm not looking forward to. But I'm already dirty up, so might as well get it done. Okay.
All right, so we got the old one off. New one on. This is not how I'm assembling it. I still gotta do it piece by piece, but we're just trying to make sure I had it on there right. So, all right, back down we go. Excuse us. You want to crank her up?
Yeah, fire her up. We'll see if she leaks.
Go for it.
Get out of here. I know what you're trying to do. Get.
Oh, she just went up under the calf.
I don't care. She's going to get out. Do I have to hold the key? Or?
You just put the key in the on position for like 5 seconds. The button to your, the left.
Yeah, I'm waiting on the clicker.
Yeah. I don't hear an air leak, y'all. I don't hear an air leak.
Lucky, let it build all the way up.
Oh no, I was trying to do a pre-air check. One more air leak. Oh yeah, I'm missing the bag for that.
I got some soap in there. We'll spray the fittings.
Yeah. Okay.
75.
All right, y'all. I was listening for air leaks. I'm so used to hearing air leaks, my conscience is telling me that I hear something.
I hear it too.
Oh, you hear
it? As soon as we get away from it for a minute.
Yeah. My ear's still ringing.
It's what do you call it? A figment of our imagination.
Yeah.
All right. You've been hearing so many.
I know, right? Whose is this? This is mine. All right, y'all. That's done. We're gonna finish up the bumper, finish mounting it. Got a few more bolts to put it in. And then we're gonna finish out the grill.
What caveman?
Let me get that bottom first.
Okay.
Take it to Blue Beacon.
Yeah, but then fucking they hit it. Mm-hmm. So we'll just hit the big blue spots and then let them do the rest.
All right, so y'all got to see a little sneak peek there. But we're going to be taking off the sticky tomorrow. So you have to tune in to the next video to see new to the channel, I had the old bumper broke, the bracket to it broke, and it went up and sliced my lower radiator on. It's all right, my lower radiator hose. I'm gonna have to
go. Got it going your way yet?
Yep.
Awesome, awesome. Here, you want to make it easy on yourself?
What are we doing? Oh, no, this comes right off.
Oh, does it?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is just my patchwork for temporary.
Patchwork. Make it get home.
Yeah, I know, right? Might be a little warm since we just ran it.
Oh, that was gonna shoot this way, so I just let it go. Yeah, if you want, you can go ahead and pop that. What size is that one? Crescent wrench, it's just a square bolt. Oh, it's a square. So yeah, my lower radiator, the old bracket broke and it pierced my lower radiator hose, so I ended up catching pneumonia due to this too, because it was freaking cold.
And it was raining. As soon as I stepped out to fix it, I think I have to at a shipper in Louisiana.
Appreciate it.
All right, where are we?
It's
the one.
Yeah, right.
Was there?
No, up underneath.
You feel
it? Oh, there it is.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So yeah, guys, so while that's all, pouring out of there, thank y'all for tuning in today. So tomorrow, we're gonna do the big reveal on the grill so y'all can see what I got. Just know I paid more for it than I had in my budget. I did, but it would definitely be well worth it in the future. Guys, thank y'all for checking out today. Make sure you like, share, subscribe, comment, and all that good stuff. Follow me on Instagram, Official Lone Star Texas Ranger, and the Facebook group, the link down to there is down there in the description below. I usually post stuff in those groups before y'all see it on the channel. If y'all want to see the VIP stuff beforehand, check out those channels, those social media links. There's a bunch of stuff down there in my description, y'all. So y'all check it out. There's a bunch of resources down there. But I think we're about done here. So we got to do this, and then the fan club solenoid, and we're done. So tune in to noon Central Standard Time tomorrow to see the finished product.